You know that you can view a matrix as the implementation of some linear transformation. So a matrix and a transformation are intimately related. What about the determinant of a matrix? Does that tell us something about the linear transformation? Yes, it certainly does, as you will see in this video. So, what is a determinant if you relate it to a linear transformation? We look at 2x2 matrices, so we take a transformation T from R2 to R2, T linear, so we know that it is implemented by some matrix A, T of X equals A times X, where A consists of the image of E1 and the image of E2. Let's call them A1 and A2, columns of A. So, how does that look in a figure? So, we have an E1, and the image of E1 equals A1, and we have our unit vector E2, and the image of E2 is A2. So that's how we form our matrix A. Now, what about determinants? Now, we can form, say, the rectangle or the parallelogram formed by E1 and E2. That's easy. It's the unit square, so its area is just 1. And we can form the parallelogram formed by A1 and A2. And we get this parallelogram over here. Now, the area of that parallelogram is given by the determinant of the matrix with its columns A1 and A2. Aye, but that's exactly our matrix A. So the area of our image, the area of our image here over here, of our parallelogram, is exactly the modulus of the determinant of A. So we start with an area of 1 over here, and then our image has an area of determinant of A. So our area of our parallelogram is the determinant of A1 and A2 times, actually, we can put a 1 here, so equals modulus of that A times the area of our square. So what happens, the determinant of A tells you how much bigger your image has grown. It gives you the amplification factor of your mapping. So that is what the determinant of your matrix A tells in conjunction with linear transformations. It tells you how much bigger or how much smaller your image is with respect to the original